In my high school physics class, I was scarred with the image of chain reaction as demonstrated by the old ping pong ball and mousetrap demo. So I thought it was only appropriate that I would scar all of you today with that same image. I'll let it speak for itself. I'll launch the ball. Now that's a lot of stuff going on at the same time. Again, a great example of the CPU doing all of this collision, all of this physics at the same time to grab the processor and render the scene for it. In fact, this thing has a lot of techniques that turns out at 120 hertz you have to employ to make the scene look realistic. One of them is motion blur. I can slow time down and trigger this ball. You can see that it's fuzzy. That's good, getting some good motion blur. Of course, it didn't hit anything. Oh, no, it did. Typically, it really screws me there and doesn't actually get anything. So the thing to think about here is the fact that the CPU, completely independently of the graphics chip, can do all of this physics and all of this stuff very, very easily. You don't have to worry about tension. You don't have to worry about bandwidth. This has the gap node too.